the end of the bill, right? Promise to the smoke stamp.
Get into our convoy to bypass traffic too, and that they're even opening up the road to let tourists who have hotel reservations check in. Lahaina does not have the resources. There's no electric. Kilauea Mauka doesn't even have running water. They haven't had water since the whole storm happened. Their water supply at LIS got cut off. But you can let tourists come into Lahaina and enjoy our beaches when still get bodies floating in the water, still get dead bodies around Lahaina that they never even find yet. How? You guys expecting these families to come into work and serve these tourists when they lost everything they had? And it's absolutely disgusting that at 12 o'clock they open the roads. People who like go into Lahaina, who live in Lahaina,
what lives there, what descendants live there, you know why. And you know why it happened on 8-8. It's not something that you see. And you know why it happened on 8-8.
I want you to look at this guy's page, go to his Instagram, and follow him. He's talking about how people are trying to bring in supplies such as water, food, and gas, and they are being turned away. The military is turning away people from helping, and he was talking about this on his page. Now, if we take it a step further, the governor was asked, why didn't the system go off when the fires were happening? And he was basically saying it must have been a malfunction. But what's interesting is a person commented, the siren sounds went off when there was no tsunami, but the sound when an actual burning fire disaster doesn't occur. What's also interesting about the governor was he passed this executive order just before this in July, which could take away the land from the people based on if they need to. So,
I had to think fast. We had to get out. We left our vehicle. And myself, my wife, and our 5 kids, we all got in the ocean. We found a floating board that we hung on to. And everything, we were out there floating. And it was so surreal.
One.
People in Hawaii, Father God, in Maui, and in the other city, in Lalande, or whatever that city, I can't pronounce that L city, it begins with an L in Hawaii, Father God, but I just really lift the people of Hawaii up to you today, and every day, really, Father God, because of the injustice that was done to the people in Hawaii, to the people in Maui, to their cities, to their homes and businesses, and to their lives and to their freedom, Father God, for the people to be targeted in the nation of Hawaii, in Maui, in Lalande, Father God, if I'm pronouncing that L city right, I'm probably not, but forgive me, guys, if I'm not. Now it's in the L city of Hawaii, right? Because I don't know how to pronounce it. Anyway, but the people in Hawaii, Father God, I just pray that you will comfort them on every side, Father God, that you will send your comforting angels around them to comfort them for all the people in Hawaii that lost loved ones, Father God, to death and to the disasters, to the created disasters by the powers to be, Father God, that should not be, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. I pray, Father God, that you, Heavenly Father God, will heal the hearts of the wounded in Hawaii that have lost loved ones, their homes, their businesses, their lives, Father God, pets, cars, and lost their freedom and liberty, Father God, and voices, Father God,
for the hunchos to take over their nation, Father God, to take over their land and property out of selfish gain and greed, out of capital greed and gain, Father God. Because you said, Father God, in your word that the love of money, Father God, for the love of money is the root of all evil. And because of the love of money from these hunchos, Father, because they love money more than anything and more than anyone, they set up these situations to put people in squalor, Father God, not only in Hawaii, but everywhere in the world, in the places that they want to target that have the good resources and souls and sources, rather, Father God, and lands and properties and stuff, something that they want. And Father God, this was totally an injustice towards the people in Hawaii, and this has been happening to them a long time, for the hunchos to come in their nation to take over, to kill innocent people in various devious, underhanded ways, Father God, to take the land and properties and take over the businesses and create businesses in the nation of Hawaii that's not beneficial to the people, and to make the people in Hawaii servants to them, while the people in Hawaii is put down to squalor, to pennies, to not be able to take care of themselves, but to look after the rich and the wealthy in their nation that have taken over their nation, Father God, unjustly. So, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray, Father God, for your supernatural intervention, Father God, today and every day in the nation of Hawaii, upon all Hawaii people, native Hawaiian people that was natively born there from ancestry blood, Father God. I pray that you will bring justice for the people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, and in the city of Maui, in the city of Lalande, Father God, in the L city. I just call it an L city because I can't pronounce the name for some reason. I just keep even forgetting that name of the city, or it's a mental block or something. But anyway, and I can't pronounce it either. So anyway, I call it the L city that got attacked. And the businesses that got attacked in the L city in Hawaii, Father God, as well as Maui, Father God, because Maui and every city, you know, in Hawaii is so beautiful. And I hate to see the destruction that was caused upon such a beautiful nation of Hawaii that was so full of your beauty and nature, Father God. And not only they just kill people, but they kill animals too, Father God. They kill babies and children, Father God, which you hate doing these storms and fires, Father God, these set up fires and stuff, Father God, that was set up and that was blamed on the wind, but it was some human agents of the devil tampering with things, Father, because you are the God who sees all. You saw everything behind closed doors and underhandedly. You see everything, and your eyes never miss anything, Father God. You saw everything that happened in Hawaii, Father God, in the cities of Hawaii that got targeted several days ago with the creative weather, the bad storms, the weather that was created by human agents of the devil and by the fires, Father God. And the people was not being rescued. They wasn't being allowed to escape the fires in the cars or in their homes or whatever. They was being blocked by the authorities, Father God, to be able to get out of their cars, to be able to drive away from the fire, to be escaping from the fire so they wouldn't burn alive in their cars. And the children have gotten burned, and even animals and properties and land. So I pray for you to interfere, Father, to bring justice, that you release your angels of justice to bring justice for the people in the nation of Hawaii, and that you will release restoration upon the people of Hawaii in the way that the people in Hawaii do not have to beg and plead and be servitude to their oppressors that have oppressed them, Father, in their nation. Father God, they don't have to beg in the line for food, beg for a business, beg for a job, beg for a handout, Father God, beg for a place to lay their head. But I pray that you move on the hearts of the people in the nation of Hawaii to put their trust in you, Father God, because you are Jehovah Jireh, the Lord, the provider that can provide for them much better than any man could ever do, Father God. Much better than they could ever do for themselves in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, and any given nation, Father, in Jesus Christ's name. I pray that you move on the hearts of the people of the nation of Hawaii, Father God, to turn to you, to turn to Jesus, because Jesus is the only one that can deliver them out of this dilemma and set them free and deliver them out of bondage and tyranny and oppression and out of totalitarianism and communism in their nation by the oppressors that are keeping them bound in tyranny and in totalitarianism and communism, Father God, in their nation, in Jesus Christ's name. And I pray, Father God, that you will help the people in Hawaii, Father God, to band together some kind of way to stick together, Father God, and fight, Father God, fight to rebel against totalitarianism, Father God, to rebel against slavery and imprisonment, Father God, and captivity and proclivity and exile and servitude, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name, that you will give the people in Hawaii your strength in their hearts and their spirit, souls and bodies and their minds to rebel against their oppressors, Father God, and to figure out a way, Father God, to give them wisdom and knowledge and understanding how to get those controller handlers out of their nation, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father God, that you will give them wisdom, Father God, in the name of Jesus, and for the ones that turn on their own people in Hawaii, that you release your strong rebukes of your correcting fires and convictions upon the natives in Hawaii that turn on their own people, Father God, doing this evil situation, cruel situation, in Jesus Christ's name, Father God. I pray, Father God, that you will convict the hearts of the ones that mistreated the people, especially the native Hawaiians that turn on the native Hawaiians, Father God, and not help them, Father God, that's working for the law enforcement, the fire department, or whatever agency, Father God, that think was wrong, that you bring them to repentance and that you release your correcting fires and convicting fires upon their hearts, Father God, to repent and turn away from their wicked ways, Father God, and to open up their eyes to show them where they erred and turn it against their own native people, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father God, and not to obey evil orders from their superiors when it comes to endangering someone's life and destroying someone's life and somebody's freedom and property and homes and businesses and their voice, Father God, and their lives, in Jesus Christ's name. I pray, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that you will release your strong rebukes and your correcting fires upon the hunchos, Father God, that have oppressed the Native Hawaiians, Father God, and stole their land and property and businesses and lives and freedom from them all these years. It's not just recently that they've been doing these seizings against the people and the nation of Hawaii, but they've been doing this to the Hawaiians for many, many generations and years ago, Father God, for many years. So, Father, I pray that you put a stop to this cruelty, to this totalitarianism, to this bondage and slavery and imprisonment of the people of the nation of Hawaii in Maui and in Lalande and the L City, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. By your mighty power and your strength and your anointing in Jesus Christ's name. So, Father God, I pray that you will move on the hearts of Hawaiian people, Father God, to repent for anything that they need to repent for in any time that they have participated in anything, and even trusting in other men is a sin, and have not trusted in you, Father God, and even trusting in themselves, but not trusting in you, and even doing any type of dark religions that has opened the door for demons to attack their nations through evil human agents of the devil, through evil rulers, Father God, of the devil. In Jesus Christ's name, Father God, that you will cause the hearts of Hawaiian people to repent for any sin that they have committed against you and disobeying you and in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, because you say in your word that any nation that obey you and worship you and not serve other gods, not serve other idols, any idols, and to obey your word and to love you, Father God, and keep your commandments, you will bless that nation when they keep your commandments and they don't put no other gods before you, Father God, and they don't worship idols, but they worship and serve you and obey your word, Father God, and turn to Jesus and be integrous and Christ-centered, Father God. And I'm not implying that the people in Hawaii has done anything evil to cause this injustice to happen to them that has broken out like several days ago with the fires and the disaster weather that was created by evil human agents of the devil, Father God. I'm not implying that at all. I'm just saying, Father God, that as a nation, every nation, all of us, including the nation of America, we need to repent, because America ain't no angels either, Father God. We are doing a lot of wicked stuff in the nation of America. And I pray that you deal with Americans that go over there, Father God, as leaders and buy out the land, the properties in Hawaii that just sit there and oppress the Hawaiian people and take over their land and businesses and create businesses that's not profitable to anyone, Father God, to the Hawaiians, especially to the Hawaiians, but it's profitable to the honchos, the rich honchos, Father God. So, Father God, I pray that you bring them to repentance, Father God, and convict them to let these evil honchos that came over there and just taken advantage of Hawaii all these years to repent. And if they don't repent, Father God, I pray that you will execute your judgment and your vengeance and your punishment upon the cruel human agents of the devil that have destroyed the nation of Hawaii and Maui and that L City and other cities in the nation of Hawaii behind climate created control weather and behind disaster fires and behind other underhanded devious schemes, Father God, just to get power and wealth and control over the people of the nation of Hawaii, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that you will execute your judgment and vengeance upon the ones that created these disasters of bad weather and fires, Father God, just to steal the properties and the lands of the nation of Hawaii and Maui and in the L City and other cities in Hawaii over all these years, Father, not just recently. Father God, in Jesus Christ's name, that you will bring your jubilees for the people and your justices for the people in the nation of Hawaii that have been abused and oppressed and enslaved and bullied and disrespected and usurped and violated, Father God, in so many varieties of ways, that you will bring justice and restoration and reconciliation to the land of Hawaii and to the native people in Hawaii and to all the Hawaiians that unjustly got killed behind somebody else's greed and selfishness, Father God. All these years, not just recently in Maui and stuff, Father God, that you will bring justice for the people in Maui and in the L City that have lost lives and businesses and homes and cars and land where things have been destroyed very profoundly and very bad by the greedy, selfish, evil human agents of the devil, Father God, that came against the people in Hawaii, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I just pray that you will provide, Father God, for the people in the nation of Hawaii that have lost so much, that you'll provide every resource, every besides wisdom, knowledge, and understanding and discernment to discern who their oppressors really are and how the devil really operates, Father God, through evil people, Father God, to destroy and take over their nation and over them, to make slaves out of them, Father God. I pray that you will provide the food, the shelter, the medical supplies, the finances, Father God, the resources to rebuild the nations and the cities that got destroyed behind this disastrous fires and disaster weather, in the mighty name of Jesus, and that you will provide them a lot of love and tender loving care and favor and grace and mercy and kindness and sincere help, Father God, from sincere people. That you will send true, sincere, genuine people out there and strong, authentic Christians out there in Maui, in the L City, and anywhere in Hawaii to help the people that have been wounded and hurt and targeted by this disaster fires and disaster weather and lost so many loved ones behind these fires, Father God, and these loved ones were not able to escape because they wasn't allowed to escape, Father God, because the evil rulers have prohibited them from being able to escape the fires so they can just be allowed to burn up in their cars, Father God. And the people wanted to get out and they wasn't allowed to get out of their cars or drive through or get out of buildings or whatever. And they wasn't allowed any water, Father God, to be able to burn out their fires. The fires that these evil human agents of the devil has created in Maui and in any other city, the L City in Hawaii, Father God. So I pray that you will bring, Father God, hope and healing and the gospel of Jesus Christ in the nation of Hawaii. In the hope of Jesus, that Jesus is their only hope and Jesus is the only one that can help them and keep them delivered and deliver them from tyranny, from the totalitarians, from the controller handlers, Father God. from the high-level wizards and dark sorcerers, Father God, that want to oppress them from the pharaohs and the Egyptians, Father. And I pray that you deliver the people, Father God, and the nation of Hawaii from Pharaoh, from the spirit of Pharaoh, from the spirit of Egyptian, Father God, that's operating through the high-level leaders in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name, that you will break this evil spirit of Pharaoh and Egyptian off of the people and the nation of Hawaii with your power and your anointing, the power of the Holy Spirit and the blood of Jesus off of the people and Hawaii in Jesus Christ's name. And I pray that you will release your fire, Father God, to burn and destroy the wicked spirit of Pharaoh and Egyptian, the wicked spirit of Mammon, the wicked spirit of Antichrist, the wicked spirit of murder and hatred, the wicked spirit of control and totalitarianism, Father God, the wicked spirit of greed, Father God, and Satanism and selfishness, the wicked spirit, Father God, of witchcraft, Father God, and the wicked spirit of religion, Father God, out of the nation of Hawaii with your consuming fires, that you will cause these evil entities and deities that I just mentioned and the ones that I did not mention to catch your fire and be consumed and burn into ashes with your consuming fires, down to ashes, Father, in Jesus Christ's name, tonight. Father God, I pray that you will cover all the people in the nation of Hawaii with the blood of Jesus, that you will cover their spirit, souls, and bodies, and their lives, their minds, their memories, their personalities, and wills, and intellects, Father God, with the blood of Jesus, that you'll preserve and protect and cover their lives and their health, the blood of Jesus, and whatever they got left over, their nation and their land, Father God, and properties and homes, whatever's left over, cars, their families and their loved ones and children and pets and animals and the oceans and the waters with the blood of Jesus in Jesus Christ's name. And I ask that you release your warrior angels in the nation of Hawaii to bind up all principalities, powers, rulers, and darkness of this world and spiritual wickedness that rise up against the people and the nation of Hawaii into war and fight against every evil entity and deity that fight and against the Hawaiians and that want to kill the Hawaiians, that want to attack the Hawaiians and target the Hawaiians, Father God, to bring them into total servitude and submission to evil rulers in Jesus Christ's name that don't mean them any good. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father God, I just pray, Father God, that you will send your angels, your warrior angels in the nation of Hawaii, in the city of Maui, and in this L city, Father God, that I can't pronounce, to remove all unrighteousness and wickedness and to destroy every satanic, demonic foundation, to remove evil rulers out of the nation of Hawaii, out of Maui, and out of the L city and any other city in the nation of Hawaii with your power and your anointing and your supernatural hand flow, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, and to replace the government and Hawaii with righteous, God-fearing people, God-fearing men, in Jesus Christ's name, that you'll restore the government in the nation of America with the right, God-fearing people, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name, and that you'll remove these evil, controlling, totalitarian murderers out of the nation of Hawaii in the name of Jesus, Father God, with your mighty power, with your mighty strength, with your power and your anointing that destroys every yoke and removes every burden out of the nation of Hawaii Father God, and that you will deliver the people from all captivity of slavery and imprisonment and captivities and proclivities, from controller handlers, Father God, from oppressors, from totalitarians, from tyrannical tyrants, Father God, in their nation, in Jesus Christ's name. And I pray that you will release your correcting fires and convictions upon the law enforcement, Father God, the police, the firefighters, and all that was negligent to rescue the people in the nation of Hawaii, in Maui, and in the L City, Father God, and any other city in Hawaii, Father God, from danger and harm and murder, in Jesus Christ's name, that you will deal with them, Father God, that you will release your voice to them and speak to them, that you will send ministering angels and minister to them for what they have done unjustly to the people and the nation of Hawaii with these cruel fires and cruel weather attacks, Father God, to cause so much death and tyranny and oppression and despair upon the people in the nation of Hawaii and in Maui and in the L City that I can't pronounce, and other cities in Hawaii, all who was affected in Hawaii, because I think everybody was affected in the nation of Hawaii, even though this occurred in Maui and in the L City. Father God, everybody in the nation of Hawaii was affected by it, Father God, not just the people in these cities that was attacked several days ago with fires and death and disaster weather, Father God. So anyway, Father God, I pray that you heal the land of Hawaii and the hearts of the people and Hawaii, and that you'll restore, Father God, their land back to them. They will be able to have their land back, their people back, their freedom back, their control back, to be able to rule over their own government and themselves. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that you restore Hawaii like it used to be, Father God, back to freedom and liberty, so people can be able to provide for themselves and their loved ones and their families, and so people can be able to work, Father God, and own businesses without getting paid nothing, because they don't hardly get paid anything, Father God. It's below minimum wage, Father God. They get to eat, and that's about it, maybe, Father God, and some don't even get to eat, Father God. So, Father God, the honcho rich people are there eating off of the good of the land and Hawaii and their resources and minerals and everything, Father God, while the native Hawaiians don't get to eat, and they making a penny less than a dollar, Father God. So, or making nothing, and they can't pay their bills, they can't buy food for themselves or their family members, loved ones, and can't buy a decent home or whatever, Father God. And then a lot of their homes got destroyed behind the bad weather that has been happening to Hawaii for several years. It's not just this breakout in Maui just recently, but Hawaii has been getting attacked a lot lately, especially for the last several years, very, very hard. Targeted very, very hard with bad weather, whether it's tsunamis or tornadoes and hurricanes or overfloods of water, Father God, or what they call volcanoes, Father God. My goodness, Father God. So the people in Hawaii has went through a lot for the last several years, but they was always being attacked for many years because they have rich resources there that evil, greedy people want. So evil, greedy people come in their lands and take over and steal their stuff from their resources and minerals and their homes and businesses, Father God. And if they can't get people to sell their property in Hawaii, they just create bad weather and and disaster fires just to burn people off of their land, even if they have to kill them in fires, just to get their land and property. Father God, which is very wicked in your eyes and very much of abomination unto you, Father God, because you have in your word, in your Ten Commandments, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill, Father God. And thou shalt not strive against his neighbor without a cause, Father God. And when people break your laws, it's a consequence. And I pray that you let the evil hunchos know in Hawaii that it's a consequence, a penalty of judgment that will fall upon these evil doers, these evil human agents of the devil that mistreated and killed and robbed the people in Hawaii. Your judgment will fall upon them, and that you will let them know you're not going to let them get away for what they did to the people in Hawaii all these years, for many years, and what they did to the people in Hawaii just recently in Maui and in the L City or any city surrounding Maui. In the nation of Hawaii, Father God, your karma will come upon these evil human agents of the devil that have killed and destroyed, Father God, the people in the nation of Hawaii. One of these days, in your own timing, in your own way, Father God, because you are the only judge, and there is nothing but justice and righteousness and fairness in your heavenly court, Father God. And you are the judge who judges righteously and fairly. And I thank you for judging righteously and fairly in the situation of Hawaii, Father God, and the people of Hawaii, and situation of what the hunchos did unjustly to the people of Hawaii by killing them off and letting them suffer and torture in the fires and pulling the plug of the water, pulling the plug of letting them escape from the fire. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that you release your fire upon the evil, selfish, greedy human agents of the devil that did this to the people in the nation of Hawaii, in Maui, and in the L City, in any city surrounding Maui, and that was affected by this disaster storm and fire and all the other evil stuff that these evil rulers have done against the people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I just pray, Father God, that you will also provide, Father God, the people in the nation of Hawaii courage and boldness to stand against their tyrants and their bullies and their oppressors, Father, to fight back, that you will give them the strength, the courage, and the boldness to fight back against their oppressors and to take a stand, Father God, and that you will open up the eyes to show them that this was done to them by the devil through human agents of the devil, Father God, working for the devil, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ's name, Father God. But you are a God of justice, Father God, and I thank you for bringing justice for the people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, for all the unjust things that have been done against them for many, many years in their nation from all types of evil human agents of the devil that works for the devil, Father God, against the people of the nation of Hawaii, in Jesus Christ's name. And Father, I pray that you will unleash your fire to burn and destroy these wicked, controlling spirits, manipulative spirits, these spirits of theft and debt and lack and shortage, Father God, these demon spirits of tyranny and oppression, Father God, and suppression and repression and possession and depression, Father God, with the fires of the Holy Spirit down to the ashes to the ground tonight in the nation of Hawaii in Jesus Christ's name. And I pray that you restore the hearts of the people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, to be at your peace, that you will release your peace and your joy and your contentment upon their hearts, Father, because the people in the nation of Hawaii are very angry about all the injustices done against them for many, many years, and especially even now, recently, Father God, that was done to them in Hawaii and Maui and in that L city and all cities surrounding Maui, Father God, in Hawaii, Father God, and they have a right to be angry because it's injustice. And Father God, I thank you that you are more than powerful to bring justice for the people and the nation of Hawaii. It is never nothing too hard for you to do, even in disasters, Father God. You can do miracles all the time, and I pray that you release your miracle working power in the nation of Hawaii among the native Hawaiians that have lost so many things and so many loved ones and people and even their self-esteem and their self-worth and their freedom and dignity, Father God, and liberty. I thank you for restoring the liberty and the freedom back to the people in the nation of Hawaii, and that they will be free from being bond slaves to the evil human agents of the devil, the evil rulers in their nation, Father God of Hawaii, in Jesus Christ's name. I thank you for breaking the hand and the foot off of the necks of the people of the nation of Hawaii, and breaking, destroying every satanic bond, Father God, off of the necks of the people of Hawaii with your power and your anointing in the blood of Jesus, Father, in Jesus Christ's name, and also with the power of the Holy Spirit, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that you release your shaloms upon the hearts and the lives of the people in the nation of Hawaii that have lost so much just recently, Father God, and so much over many years, Father God, that you release your grace and your mercy and your favor to release your shaloms of all types of well-being and blessings upon the nation of Hawaii, upon all the native Hawaiians, Father God, everywhere in Hawaii, that have been taken advantage of and abused and oppressed and stolen from and just disrespected and overjacked and usurped and violated in various ways by evil rulers in their nation and evil human agents of the devil in their nation that's working for the devil against them, in Jesus Christ's name. So, Father God, I give this situation over to you in Maui and the L city and all over Hawaii and the people over to you. I pray that you will just look after the people in Hawaii and provide for them in every way. Their spiritual needs, their emotional, mental, psychological needs, Father God. And to provide their financial needs and housing needs, Father God, material needs, medical needs, Father God, social needs, Father God, and that you will bring the right kind of people in to aid in their nation that will not take advantage of them, Father God, but that will sincerely give them true aid without any strings and games and schemes attached to it. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father God, to the people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. Father God, I just thank you that you love the people in Hawaii because you created the people in Hawaii too, Father God. You love them dearly, Father God. You love them dearly. And Jesus died for the people in Hawaii too. So, Father, I thank you for restoring the people in the nation of Hawaii to Jesus, to your salvation, Father God, through the blood of Jesus Christ, the atonement blood of Jesus Christ upon the people in the nation of Hawaii and every city in the nation of Hawaii, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I ask that you cover and seal these prayers, Father God, in the blood of Jesus upon the people of Hawaii and upon my prayers in this podcast episode and speaker podcast episodes and shows and speaker with the blood of Jesus, and that you will cover me with the blood of Jesus in Jesus Christ's name and protect my speaker podcast shows and this episode with the blood of Jesus and the uploading of this episode with the blood of Jesus in Jesus Christ's name. And I pray that you destroy any witchcraft that's being sent against any of the Hawaiians, Father, any black magic, dark sorcery, voodoo, hoodoo, evil eye, Father God, off of the lives of the people in the nation of Hawaii with the blood of Jesus, that you will leash your fire to burn and destroy any black magic, murder spirits, witchcraft attacks, Father God, spells, enchantments, bewitchments, curses, hexes, vexes, jinxes, and omens off of the people in the nation of Hawaii, which are consuming fires, Father God, down to ashes in Jesus Christ's name. And that you will put a stop to the tyranny and the slavery and the harassment and the evil targeting of against the people of the nation of Hawaii, the native people in Hawaii, with your mighty supernatural power and your supernatural hand flow and the power of the Holy Spirit and with the power of the blood of Jesus in Jesus Christ's name, I pray that you destroy every satanic plan that the devil and his demons have plotted against the native Hawaiians in Hawaii, Father God, in every city in Hawaii, with the blood of Jesus, with your power and your anointing, with the power of the Holy Spirit, and with the fires of the Holy Ghost down to the ashes to the ground tonight, and that you release the consuming, driving fires of the Holy Spirit to drive out every evil human agent, every evil tyrant out of the nation of Hawaii, Father, with the fire of the Holy Spirit in Jesus Christ's name, and that you release the fire of the Holy Spirit to drive out every evil entity and deity of Pharaoh and Egyptian out of the nation, Father God, of Hawaii in Jesus Christ's name, and that you release, that you will drown every Pharaoh and Egyptian that rise up against the people in the nation of Hawaii with the blood of Jesus, in the blood of Jesus, in the sea of the blood of Jesus, in the sea of the blood of Jesus, in Jesus Christ's name. I thank you for releasing the blood against every Pharaoh and Egyptian that come against the people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, to dispel the unrighteousness, to break the chains of slavery and tyranny off of the necks of the people, Father God, of Hawaii, in Jesus Christ's name. And I thank you for drowning every Pharaoh and Egyptian that come against any native Hawaiian in the nation of Hawaii, in the sea of the blood of Jesus Christ, in the sea of the blood of Jesus Christ, every Pharaoh and Egyptian spirit and every Pharaoh and Egyptian that come against them in the natural realm, against the people in Hawaii, in the natural realm, in the sea of the blood of Jesus Christ, and dispelling every evil assignment of the devil off of the people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, in Maui, in the L City, in every city in the nation of Hawaii, in the blood of Jesus, with the blood of Jesus Christ in Jesus Christ's name, Father. Father, thank you for taking care of the Hawaiians and loving on them, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. Thank you that this prayer is done and answered, Father, in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Save the Hawaiians, save Hawaii, save Hawaii, save the people in Hawaii. Oh Lord my God, oh Lord my God, oh Lord my God, save the people, save the people, save the people in Hawaii, in Hawaii, Lord, in Maui, Lord, in every city in Hawaii, Lord, save the people, save the people, save the people, oh my Lord, in Hawaii, in Hawaii, Lord, save the people, deliver the people in Hawaii, Lord, out of the hand of the devil, out of the hand of Pharaoh, unto your hand, unto your mighty hand, my Lord, O Lord, my God, save the people, save the people, save the people in Hawaii. Oh Lord my God, oh Jesus Christ, oh Lord my God, oh Lord my God, for you are the only one who can save the people in Hawaii. Oh Jesus Christ, oh Jesus Christ, oh Jesus, oh Lord my God, oh Lord my God, save the people, save the people today, right now, and every day in Hawaii, in Hawaii, in Hawaii, Lord, oh Lord my God, oh Lord my God, hallelujah, 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 God, hallelujah, Jesus, oh, 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 oh. Kere de kosoro vakasivi korobo kosuria, ere kasivi korobo kosoro vakasivio. Kere kanoro kosivi kanara kasa ara keriviro, asavo korobo korivi kere de kalavakasu urivi kere de kalavuria, ere kaso oro vakasavo koruria, asivi kosavo koshia. Kere kasa ara kasuria, asavo koruria, ere kasivi korobo koso oro vakasivi korobo koso oro vakasivi korobo kosia, ere kasivi korobo kashivi korobo kosovo koshia. Father, when the people in the nation of Hawaii repent for whatever sins they have done against you and done against others and against your people, anything and what you have ever created, you will heal their land, Father God, when they turn away from sin and turn to you and turn to Jesus and submit to you, Jesus, and submit to your kingdom of righteousness and to you as Lord, Father God. When they first seek your kingdom and your righteousness, and all these things will be added to the people in the nation of Hawaii, they must seek you and turn away from their wicked ways and return to you and turn to righteousness and turn to Jesus, Father God, and repent of their sins and turn to righteousness, Father, and you will heal their land, Father God, and their nation, and will restore what the everything that the devil has stolen from them, Father God. So I thank you for moving on the hearts of people in Hawaii, including the evil hunchos in Hawaii, to repent for all their sins and turn to Jesus, turn to righteousness, and give up their idols, Father God, and to die to themselves and to live for Jesus and turn to Jesus and receive Jesus Christ as a personal Lord and Savior, because Jesus Christ is the only one that can help the people in the nation of Hawaii and even in Maui and in the L city that I can't pronounce, in Hawaii, in every city in Hawaii, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name, Father God. Koroboko shivi kerevoko so orebe kerevi koroboko doria ereka sivi koroboko so orebe kerevi o korovaka sivi kerevaka savoka shivia kosovoka shivi kerevoka shivi kerevoko doria asavo koroboko shivia ereka so orebo korovaka sivio oraka se erehera kaso orebo kuria ereka so orebo koshivi kerevoko doria ereka so orebo korovaka sivi kerevoko orovaka suri koroboko shivia asavo koruria ereka Sibi Kuroboko so orbe kereva kosuru Kuroboko Lora Garcia. Kerevoko sivi kereva kasivi Kurobaka sivi Kuroboko sia. Kereka so orbako sivi kereka savoko sivi kerevoko sivia. Kuroboko sivi kerevoko sivi kerevoko sia. Kereka sovoko sivi kerevoko sivi kereva. Kuroboko sivi kerevoko so. Kereveko sovoko sivi kesavo. Kereka so orokoto garaka sia. Kereka sovo kashivi kereva kashivi kereva kasova kashia kerevo hoso orava kasivi koroboko la kasi ereka la la koruria ereka so orava kotore kasivi koroboko la kasivi koroboko la kasuria ereka turia kasavo koroba kasi ire rakasa nobo koroba kasivi koroboko la kanaka la kere ereka suria vokoroba kosuria ereka solo koroba kanaka la korore ve kosuria ve koroba kanaka la kosuria nabo koroba kasivi koroboko sivi kereva kosivia ereka so ora vaka sivi koroboko sivi karavako so ereka leve korobaka savo koribeka la kaso ora kazia nava korobika savo koribia. Now all you wonderful native Hawaiians, I'm going to play some wonderful music for you wonderful Hawaiians, native Hawaiians out there in this episode. But I just want you to know that Jesus loves you and he cares about you, and he's upset with the wicked and angry with the wicked every day. And he's angry with the wicked ones that came against you. And he will judge and punish the wicked ones that came against you, wonderful Hawaiians, and what was done against you many, many years, and even recently in Maui and in the L city. So God will bring justice for you. He cares. He sees everything, and nothing never misses his eyes. Because God sees much greater than the eye of Horus, much greater than the eye of Lucifer. So, precious Hawaiians, God has not forgotten about you. He's looking out for you. He will take care of you if you dare to believe and trust in Jesus and in Jehovah God. He will take care of you and will deliver you, because he is the only one that can deliver you. Jesus is the only one that can deliver you and bring true freedom and paradise for you. Wonderful Hawaiians, for everything that has been stolen from you, God will restore. God is a God of reconciliation. He's a God of miracles. He's a God of restoration. He's a God of freedom and liberty and love. God is a God of goodness, and his goodness is upon you, O precious Hawaiians. God is coming in with his aid very soon. O precious Hawaiians, he loves you. He cares very much for the injustices that has been done against you for many, many years by evil, greedy, selfish human agents of the devil that came against you for many years and even recently. In Jesus' name, be at peace in Christ and receive Jesus and turn to Jesus and cleave to Jesus and put your trust in Jesus, because he is the only one that will never hurt you or abuse you or use you or never let you down. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Jesus is with you. Oh, precious Hawaiians that have lost so much in all these years, and just recently over the fires of Maui and the L City and anywhere else in Hawaii, just recently, several days ago, oh, precious Hawaiians, be in peace through Jesus Christ. In Jesus Christ's name, Jesus loves you and he is with you and for you. Oh, precious Hawaiians, forever. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, this is the first song I heard when I got to London a couple months ago. And I was like, man, I need to find an instrumental to that quick.
Don't go.
Yeah. So here we are, better late than never. Salvation Army.
I don't know where you come from.
Yeah.
But you're everywhere I go.
Yeah.
I don't know why you chose me.
I have no clue.
But as long as you're here,
that's true.
I don't need to know.
Salute.
So don't.
Yeah, that's what I say to the spirit of the Most High. Fly by, feel the rain like a crow cry. Immediately I give thanks and take a nosedive and walk right up out of that water with my clothes dry. He put me back in order in spite of my soul ties. All I need to know about my daughters is they chose God, and I could die. Through the turmoil, I burn oil, singing Feliz Navidad. In the streets, I'm seeing police homicide. Little different from what these videos dramatize. They on back lots and closed off sets, but I'm talking about back blocks and fire breathing texts. Let somebody disrespect, and I ain't even vexed. Put me out there, I ain't here for you to be impressed. I'm just here so you can see something different. I ain't banging, I ain't dealing, I ain't pimping. And to God I say, don't go,
don't leave,
don't leave.
Please stay.
Right here with me, Lord.
You yeah. are the only thing
indeed.
I need
to get by. Solid quality, you know what I mean? Yeah, yeah, yeah. What you making in the sky, my king, king? Is that New Jerusalem I see? See, you giving sight to the blind, my king. Your children can't wait till you come down, my king, 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 king. Yeah. Prophecy coming to pass. Psychological war when the chosen is ending fast. Don't ever stop short, your head might just go through the glass. Buy the truth and sell it not, it's the most valuable thing you have. Liars gon' hate you, manipulators, they gon' say you trash. Cowards gon' comment on your posts and fake pages, just laugh. You blessed when people call you evil for the sake of Yah. His love is inconceivable, it put away my crimes. He lead his sheep by the still waters, then turn the lakes to wine. So many prayers, how does mine deserve a response? That's a gift, it's no boasting in being chosen. But your emotions, you gotta rule, remain a discipline and focus. If you bow out, then it's hopeless. Don't terminate your devotion. Demons destroy peace with commotion. Sit by the ocean. Don't get peeled up when it feel rough. Get built up in the spirit. Part of me as I tilt my cup, I'm trying to fill you up with these lyrics. Yeah. What the Most High making in that blue sky? A new heaven for you and I.
Calm down.
A new heaven for you and I.
Calm down.
New Jerusalem make me wanna cry. Yeah, and my faith ain't up for debate. Transparency is the topic of discussion when I pray. And apparently, I was 8 when destiny started taking shape. Yeah, I stepped into this place with a recipe for the hate. I love my neighbor like I love myself and bless him with a plate. And like Jonathan's revelation, it was a scroll that we just ate. I'm in a solar power state and I'm melanated by grace. Who knows? Today could be the day he blows the trumpet in our face. Could be the end and then beginning like Esau and Jacob. It'd be the beginning of the end once we decide to wake up. Stop pulling these capers, chewing on razors, touching up faces. Like makeup, back to the basics. Throwing on ASICs, dipping on Satan, running amok. My father the greatest, creator of the sun that's above. Not too many haters, you hate cause it's the shade that you love. Don't do me no favors, my faith is in the rock of ages. When I'm on these stages, I'm faceless, he get all the praises. So look, what you making in the sky, my king, king? Is that New Jerusalem I see, see? You giving sight to the blind, my king. Your children can't wait till you come down, my king, king, king. What the Most High making in that blue sky? A new heaven for you and I.
Calm down.
New A new heaven, we wanna die. A new heaven, we wanna die.
We'll be right back.
Father, I pray that you will give all the Hawaiians the strength and the courage to fight fire with fire and to break out from their controllers and from the totalitarians and the tyrants that come against them and their nation and Hawaii. That you will give them the strength to stand up and to fight and to rebel, Father God, and be defiant against the devil, but be submissive to you, Father God, and that you will give them the boldness, Father God, to fight fire with fire and to break out from their controller handlers, Father God, from their oppressors, Father God. In Jesus Christ's name, Father God, and that you will deliver anyone in the nation, any of the native Hawaiians from the spirit of fear, from the spirit of fear and from the fear of man and from the fear of their oppressors, Father God. With the blood of Jesus, with your power and your anointing, that you will break the spirit of fear, Father God, that's causing the people not to stand up to the bullies in their nation of Hawaii, in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, with the blood of Jesus, with your power and your anointing, with the power of the Holy Spirit, that you will burn and destroy the spirit of fear that come against the native Hawaiians, the people in Hawaii, Father God, not to cower down anymore, not to take any more mess from the devil, Father God, nor from his human agents, the devil's human agents, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus and from the bullies and the tyrants, Father God, to take over anymore. That you will give them wisdom and boldness and courage to get these evil people out of their nation that don't belong there, Father God, that have taken over and messed up everything in Hawaii and messed up the Hawaiians. Father God, please release your fire inside of Hawaiians to fight fire, with the fire of the Holy Ghost, with the power of the Holy Spirit, with your anointing, Father God, with your power, with your fire, because you are God who answers by fire. And I pray that you will rise up, Father God, in the nation of Hawaii and with your fire, to fight fire with fire against all evil entities and deities and evil human agents and rise up against the people in the nation of Hawaii in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And that you will strengthen the people in Hawaii with your strength, with your boldness and your courage to be courageous, to be bold and stand up and fight fire with fire, especially with your fire, Father God, and your power and your anointing and your mighty strong hand of strength upon and inside of the hearts, inside the people and the nation of Hawaii, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave. Child of God, I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me, and love has called my name. I've been born again into your family,
Father, I thank you that the people that struggle with any fear, the ones that struggle with any fear in the nation of Hawaii, which I'm not going to say everybody is struggling with the spirit of fear in Hawaii, but I'm talking about the ones that do, especially the fear of man, the fear of their oppressors. Father God, I pray, Father God, and I cast out the spirit of fear, the spirit of timidity, the spirit of cowardice out of the personalities and the wills and the hearts and the souls and the minds of any native Hawaiian that is struggling with any type of fear. In the name of Jesus, by the power of you, Father God, by the power of the Holy Spirit, by the power of Jesus, and by the power of your anointing of El Shaddai, and the blood of Jesus in Jesus Christ's name. And I thank you, Father, for releasing the spirit of courage and boldness in the hearts of the people in Hawaii to be bold and break out and stand up to their tyrant bullies and oppressors and controllers and handlers. With your supernatural power and strength, and with your spirit of courage and boldness, Father God, inside of the hearts and the minds of all people in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, in Jesus' name. And I thank you that the Hawaiian people are no longer slaves to sin, but most of all, they're no longer slaves to fear, because operating in fear is a sin, according to you and your word, Father. That the people in Hawaii are no longer a slave to anyone, and the slave to the devil, the slave to the oppressors, the slave to fear, the slave to anything, the slave to mammon, the slave to oppression and imprisonment anymore, Father God, because you are the liberator and the one that set them free, that Jesus is the one that set the people and the nation free. And when Jesus set the people and the nation of Hawaii free, Father God, they are free indeed by Jesus Christ alone, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. So none of you Hawaiians are no longer slaves to fear. You are no longer slaves to anyone, oh precious Hawaiian natives, because God has given you the power through Jesus Christ, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, by the power of the blood of Jesus, to be liberated from the spirit of tyranny and slavery and oppression and fear and the fear of man and the intimidation and oppression of man, oh precious Hawaiian people, in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for helping the people in the nation of Hawaii to stand up and break out and break out and be unbreakable, Father God, with your power and your anointing, the break out of slavery, Father God, and to break out from their oppressors, controller, handlers, Father God, and from the evil ruler tyrants, Father God, that are oppressing them, Father God, with your supernatural power and your strength and your mighty strong hand upon the people in the nation of Hawaii, in every city in the nation of Hawaii. And I not only pray that for Hawaii, but I pray it for America too, Father God, because America is in totalitarian state as well. Father God, we have became a totalitarian state in America recently, Father God, for some decade or more, but Father God, even more today. So I pray this not just for Hawaii, but I pray this for every nation, and especially for America now, Father God, as well, to deliver us from being a slave to fear, a slave to our oppressors, to the fear of man, and because fear is slavery, Father God, and it's bondage, and it brings bondage and destruction for us when we operate in fear. I pray that you help us in Hawaii, all the ones in Hawaii, and even in every nation, and especially even in America, to stand up in courage and boldness to rebel against the oppressors and to break out and to fight back, that we will not be pushed over by our bully enemies. Father God, the people in Hawaii won't be pushed over by their bully enemies, Father God, anymore, Father God, because they are no longer slaves to fear, Father God, hallelujah, Father God, but they are a slave to your law, Father God, to your word, to do your word in obedience. And they are a slave to boldness and courage, Father God, to be bold and courageous against their controller handlers, against their tyrants, against their oppressors, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father God. I give you glory and honor for what you're doing in the nation of Hawaii and for all the Hawaiians, the native Hawaiians, Father God, that goes back from generation to generation, from ancient generations, Father God. The people there in Hawaii are no longer slaves, Father God, to anything. And are no longer slaves to fear, are no longer slaves to the fear of man, to the fear of their bully tyrants and oppressors, Father God, and no longer slaves to the fear, Father God, of fighting back against the evil rulers that take over in their nation, that have oppressed them, Father God, to stand up. Thank you for giving all the native Hawaiians your strength and boldness to stand up and fight back and stop taking crap, Father God, in the name of Jesus, and to stop bonding to the lies of the devil and the gaslighting lies of their enemies and their oppressors, Father God, who oppress them in the nation of Hawaii, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I thank you for quickening and awakening the hearts of the Hawaiians to show them what really happened to them and through the spiritual realm. The devil and his demons through human agents of the devil that came against him in Hawaii recently, the last several days, and all these other years, for many years, and oppressing them and destroying their nation, Father God, because Hawaii belongs to you, Father God. Everything on the earth belongs to you because you are the divine creator, Father God. You created everything and everyone. So every nation belongs to you, Father God. Everything on the earth belongs to you. All people belong to you, Father God. And it is not your will for anybody to be in slavery to anything or to anyone, Father God. Your will is for people to be free and liberated, and even free from the devil. So I thank you for delivering the people out of the hand of the devil into the hand of you, Father God, into the hand of your Lord and Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. Jesus Christ, your Son, Father God. I mean, not your Lord, but your Son, Jesus Christ. Sorry, guys. Couldn't get those words out quite like I wanted to. In Jesus Christ's name. So, Father God, I thank you that you love the people in Hawaii and you hate what the devil has done, Father God. So you will give the people in Hawaii all double for all the trouble that the devil has caused the people in Hawaii, Father God, because you are a wonderful God of justice and restoration and provision, Father God. And I thank you for fighting against the ones who fight against the people in the nation of Hawaii and contending with the ones who contend against the ones in Hawaii, Father. You are fighting for the people in Hawaii. And you are fighting all the battles for the people in Hawaii, Father God, because these battles are not for the Hawaiians to fight, Father God, because these battles are much bigger than the people in Hawaii, in the spiritual world, Father God, especially dealing with evil entities and deities and ancients of times, Father God. So I thank you for fighting against every demon that come against the Hawaiians, Father God, with your mighty strong hand, because you are a warrior fighting God that conquers and defeat all your enemies, Father God. You are the one that defeated the devil and every demon, Father God. You are a warrior fighting God that knows how to slay every demon and that know how to defeat every enemy and win every war all the time. You never lose, Father God, a fight nor a war, Father God, nor a battle. You never lose in anything, Father God. You can do everything but lose, and you can do everything but fail. And I thank you that you will not fail the people in Hawaii as they put their trust in you, and as they put their trust in your word, and as they put their trust, Father God, in your son, Jesus, who can only help them, Father God, in the nation of Hawaii. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ's name, amen.